Hello. This time we're going to try some music. Let me see if I can find it. This is from incompetech.com and it's called Magic Escape Room. And let's see what we'll open it with. There we go. Let me turn it up a little. Marathon. I'm checking to see if I can hear the music when I play it in a different device. Looks like it's pretty cute, and this is what the top looks like right here. We're gonna bust through some of these. I do use glue, you don't have to, maybe if you're more a little more exact on your folding, maybe, or thinner paper, you might be able to Well, anyway, here we go. This is a 12-inch by 18-inch, and normally when I cut it to 12-inch by 12-inch, which is good for origami, I fold it like this, and then I cut this part off. I end up with a bunch of leftover these pieces. But for this part, I am going to just keep it large because it adds extra stability to the piece. So here we go. First, I make a pinch at the halfway mark on the short side. And this is the short side. Make a pinch there. I'm having a brain fart. Let me see. That's right. So you use that pinch mark. It's sort of bright. Let's see if I can change this. Is that better? Not sure. So here's this halfway mark. Thank you. Oh, I forgot. We gotta put the gap. We need that 1 centimeter gap in the middle. So what we're gonna do on the one side of the crease that we made, we're gonna make it a 1/2 centimeter. We're gonna change the fold here. There we go. I want to make another crease on this side. Let's make sure we're doing 1/2 centimeter here. Jiving with this music. I'm going to try to change it up. Let's choose another one. Now let's try this for a while. In the meantime, increase the size a little bit more of that gap. One of these boxes. Excuse me. So I'm going to start marking the next one instead of just going by eyeballing it. Line up, take it slow. because the lid, we're going to fold each half in half. All right, to do this one in half, I like to have it folded under, so this part, I'm going to increase this. I like to have this part folded under. That part, and make a match. Line up. My voice is not so great today. Unfolded areas. This is the ledge box. I have 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 on the inside, 1 on each side of the wall. Here we go. Same thing on this side. This music makes me want to enjoy some candy. So I will. I'm just adding something to my VLC. Thank you.
was thinking I might make some shorts of some of these origami videos, some YouTube shorts. We'll see how that goes. I prefer vessels, but decorative monitos, as my mother would say, little decorative dolls, are sometimes cute. So I'll put my thinking cap on and see if I can come up with a good one. Now I got the two side panels done, the long side panels. We're going to do the short side now. And I like to, there we go. We're going to do it across two of these panels. So instead of going like this, go like this. There we go. Make a little triangle. Do it on both sides. And then we're going to make a fold along this line here. Make sure it's straight with those lines. Those lines move together. Go. More or less. Make a tight fold over. More. Now we should have three panels. They're actually double panels. So we're going to fold each one of these in half. Now, on this one, because of the length of the paper, I'm just going to leave it not tucked under. It's just going to be like this. Now the last panel, side. We've done all the folding. Now we're going to flip it around and do it on the other side. We should have, on this side, we should have six. We got one. Five, six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 panels. So, sorry for the burp. Triangles. 4. Not the first. Not as good as I would hope. Let's adjust it. Okay, one more. Fold over. One more. Now we have 3 panels. 1, 2, 3. We're going to fold each one in half. Because I need it for stability. So I just slop on some glue. Don't really need to go so much on this panel. This panel, the second panel, is the first one. It's going to fold up on. So if you put glue on here, you'll get on both. Give and move as I'm adjusting and folding things together. You can lay this flat because we've got an extra fold at the back. This is going to stand up and be the wall of the box. Pushing it up a little bit to make a nice sharp crease there. You can use this bone tool, which my aunt sent to me, and I love it. And you can put the glue out a little bit. It's a pretty good technique, in my opinion. Okay, so we're going to do this on the other side. We're doing gluing on the small sides first. Paper's a lot shorter. It's going to be short side and long side. How we're going to do this is there's the first crease and the second crease. I'm going to reinforce. And two reinforced to make it nice and sharp. Like that. That crease. Right there. Okay. We're going to do that over here. This crease like that. Make that a little more visible. There we go. All right, I'm going to fold this over. Just going to put some clips on here to hold it still for a minute while I do the other side. Put that right there. Go. Now we're going to do some glue reinforcing. Here's where I like to do the glue. Put it under here. Under here. Try to put some on this side. My paper is kind of thick. I have to push with my fingernails deep into the crease, push the paper back. So while the glue is setting and drying, it's not going to glue. Want to, you can use this needle nose glue applicator and get under there a little bit. Make sure you cover this back up. It's really hard to unclog when it gets all dried. Getting dried out in that little nozzle. I'm going to let this set for a while. Did I do the flour on top? Did I do? Okay, here. All right. We're going to make this into a pentagram. Pentagram? No. Gone. We don't need to make a full crease. We're just going to put a crease in the middle. So you got that lined up right there. There's a bit of an X. Now I'm just lining up the X. All right, we've got an X there, as you can see. Over here. Now that's open. Close corner. Put it right there on the X. Make that crease. Line this up with that. There we go. This edge. And then we're going to fold this over like that. We're going to make that crease right under there on this side. We line up these edges together. And there we go. We're ready to cut. We're going to do a cut to make this a pentagon. In here. Pentagram, star shape, sort of, almost, soon. Okay, we're going to take this edge. I'm going to fold it to the center at this point. But we're not going to make a full crease, just going to make a quick little crease. There, like that. See? All the way around. Now we're going to fold it over, and I'm going to make this touch to the middle. Now I'm going to make a crease on this paper, on this edge, not a full fold, but a crease, but I'm going to just push on the top there. So now you got that. Got a little pentagram in the center. On the same side, we're going to make a crease with a needle tool and a ruler. And on the edge of this, on one of the corners of the inner pentagram, we're going to make a line from here to where this center line touches the outer pentagram. So we're going to make a line like this. There, like that. There, I made a little crease with this needle tool and going around the corner of the inner pentagram, and now the middle of the outer pentagram, corner of the inner pentagram, middle of the outer pentagram. And corner of the inner pentagram. And middle of the outer pentagram. Corner of the inner pentagram, middle of the outer pentagram, and now we have all these creases all around. Oh, I think I ran out of music. Yeah, I did. Let me start that up again. There we go. Nice. Okay. Now, corner of the inner pentagram, I'm going to make a direct line to the edge. You want to make this into a 90 degree angle. Let's see if I can show this. There we go. Make this line. I'm going to mark this up a bit. Just this
corner. There we go. Like that. All in the same side that we did this. Remember when we did this? We took that outer fold and we made that inner like that. So this is all on the same side. And we're gonna fold this over. No, I'm sorry, wrong way. Fold it this way. There. Thank you.
star or a flower. You want to make that inner pentagram kind of flat on the table, and all these corners you want to pinch up, and then we're going to twist. Twist. Ta-da! Isn't that nice? Let's look over here. I'm going to pinch these edges of this center pentagon. And now I'm going to make this line touch this edge right here. There's a line fold right there. Watch how I do it. I'm going to push it over. And I'm going to pinch here. Make that fold a little better. So now they're all lined up. This one, over there. Going to flip it over. Fold that up a little bit. Thank you. Okay, now we're going to fold this edge of this pentagram to the center at this point. Fold that over. We're going to make a crease right there. Here's the tough part. You want to take this, tuck it into this pocket. That point goes into that pocket. This point goes into this pocket. Thank you. glue in the middle. It up. Now here's the lid. Let's get this work area cleaned up. Okay. And this will fit an A9 envelope. Well, a bunch of them. Let's make another box. That's one box down. Thank you.
nobody